I personally think the discipline of psycholinguistics would benefit from the concept of iconicity in language. That is why I have included this topic as one of the modules in this course. Let me share with you some reduplicated forms in Telugu and leave you to think about the minute differences in the events that these reduplicated forms are able to capture. That is, the sound and the meaning correspondence is not at all arbitrary. What do you think are the differences among gestures, languages, and signs, these notions? Please note, today in this lecture, the focus is not on sign languages. It is about gestures all of us use which accompany our speech. They are called co-verbal gestures. The focus of this lecture is on co-verbal gestures. Let us look at classification of co-verbal gestures. In the next couple of slides, each gesture is demonstrated. Iconic gesture resembles the actual action. Suppose I want to show you the action of cutting. I will do like this. See, we have also shown you on the screen. So this is iconic. Cutting action is iconic. Now suppose I want to say victory for peace. We make a V. V standing for victory, which also means peace. So this is kind of a metaphoric gesture. It's a little bit more conceptual. Third gesture is called beats. Beat is a gesture which controls our flow of information in the speech. It is not conceptual. We might say, to emphasize a particular point, you say either like this or like this. So in the picture, you see people trying to control the aeroplane. They want it to come down, so they're doing this. This is a beat gesture. And the gesture which is pointing, and it's extremely common even in pre-verbal children of 1.5-year-old, they point like that. If they want to leave the room, they point to the door. So pointing gestures are called iconic gestures. That also you can see on the shown on the screen.